Good morning to all. In the last class, we have discussed what it may be the term reproduction and what is the difference between the asexual to sexual method and what are the various types of asexual reproduction, including vegetative reproduction. Today, in this class, we are going to discuss the second method of reproduction, namely sexual method. Sexual reproduction involves two parental cells of opposite sex. So, they are producing male and female gametes respectively from male and female parents. Subsequently, the gametes undergo the phenomena called fusion or fertilization. This leads to variation in the formation of new species. Indirectly, this promotes genetic diversity, which is the basic material for evolution. Again, it is successful for adaptation to the changing environments. The method is elaborate, sequential, complex, but slow compared to asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction usually comprises three stages, namely juvenile stage, or we can put another way, vegetative phase. Second one is reproductive phase, and third one is senescence or old age. All the stages are directly or indirectly regulated by hormonal changes. The juvenile stage or the vegetative stage comprises the growth of the organism and maturity before the phase of sexual reproduction. It representing the entire vegetative period of the organism. The duration is variable according to the organism. The second stage is the reproductive phase, producing young ones, regulated by interaction between hormones and other environmental factors in plants, flowers, fruits and seeds. For example, in annual, biennial, multiennial, perennial plants, all these components are produced. Meanwhile, in animals, it varies in seasonal breeders and continuous breeders. What are animals? Animals are plants, complete their entire life cycle within a span of 1 year. During this stage, they germinate from the seeds, growing into a new plant, producing flowers, fruits and seed, and complete the life cycle. So that's why they are commonly called annuals. Example, rice, wheat. Second category is commonly called biennials. The word itself reflecting, bi means two. The organism completing their life cycle within a span of 2 years. In the first year, they complete the vegetative phase. Subsequently, in the second year, they produce flowers, fruits and seed. In this category, most of the plant which have got underground tubers are structures, example, carrots, beetroot, etc. Third one, the multiennial. They live for many years as non-reproducing plants, or they remain in the vegetative phase, producing flowers and fruits at the end of the life cycle, and immediately they die. Example, Strobilanthus scundianus, commonly called Neelakurinji, which lives for many years but produce flowers and fruits once in 12 years. Another example is bamboo, once in 50 to 100 years. Fourth category is perennial. They, just like the multiennial, live for many years. difficult to define the vegetative phase or the reproductive phase or even the senescence phase. Herbaceous or they may be woody. Flowers and fruits are produced in many growing seasons. Example, canna, mango, papal. In the case of animals, the organisms are categorized into seasonal breeders and continuous breeders. Seasonal breeders are reproductive active only during favorable season. Most of the wild organism belongs to this category. Meanwhile, the continuous breeders reproduce actively through the entire reproductive phase. Females of placental mammals exhibiting cyclical changes in the activities of ovaries and accessory ducts as well as hormones during their reproductive phase. In non-primates, mammals like cow, sheep, rat, deer, dog, tiger, such cyclic changes during reproduction are called by the term estrus cycle. Whereas in primates like monkey, apes and humans, it's commonly called a menstrual cycle. Many mammals, especially those live in natural wild condition, exhibit such cycles only during favorable seasons in their reproductive phase. Therefore, they are commonly called seasonal breeders. What are the major events in sexual reproduction? This will be fundamentally similar in all organisms. It is usually elaborative, sequential, and complex. It involves four major components, namely gametogenesis. Second one is gametic fusion, called by the term fertilization. Third one is formation of zygotes. Fourth one is embryogenesis. This can be also narrated as three distinct stages, namely pre-fertilization changes, fertilization changes, and the last one is post-fertilization changes. What are the events occurring during pre-fertilization changes? There are two major events. One is the gametogenesis, the word itself revealing formation of male and female gametes. Gametogenesis. Genesis means birth. Gamete formation is commonly called gametogenesis. Second is gametic transfer, bringing the male and female gametes together to facilitate or promote the event called fertilization. So these are the two changes. One is the production of gametes. Second one is the transfer of gametes to aid for the phenomena fertilization. So here again, the pre-fertilization events are narrated here. As I said earlier, gamete formation. So the gamete formation is of two type. One is it has to produce the male gametes. Similarly, it has to form the female gametes. So in this aspect, the fusion of the gametes may be of three major types. One is isogamy. Second one is anisogamy. Third one is oogamy, the most advanced one. We will see one by one. The first one is isogamy, where the gametes are morphologically and physiologically similar. Or we can put in another way, it is very difficult to distinguish the male from female gametes. So it is also called by the term homogametes or isogametes. They are similar, usually motile, naked gametes, and this form the most primitive method of sexual reproduction. Example, Chlamydomonas debarryanum, Cladophora, Ectocarpus. All these are example from algal category. Here in the lower case, you can see the diagram of isogametes of the algae called Cladophora. The second method of sexual reproduction is anisogamy. Aniso means dissimilar. So, the fusing gametes are dissimilar either morphologically or physiologically. So, that is why some people categorize anisogamy into morphological anisogamy or physiological anisogamy. So, here I have narrated like this: gametes are morphologically and physiologically dissimilar. Gametes are motile, large gametes function as female and small gametes function as males. So, the gametes are heterogametes or anisogametes. Example, Chlamydomonas brawni, Pantherina. This method is advanced than the primitive isogamy method. And third one, the most advanced one, usually seen in all higher organisms, where the fusing gametes are dissimilar both morphologically and as well as physiologically. The male gametes are smaller, motile and active. The female gametes are larger, usually non-motile, called by the term egg or ovum. Example, Chlamydomonas coxifera, Euterina, Fucus and human beings. In the lower case, you can see the male gamete as well as the female gametes. So, the female gamete is very large in size and the male gamete is represented by a small pyriform motile gametes. Similarly, in man, the female gamete is larger in size, male gamete is motile, linear, small in size. Sexuality in organism make the organism into two categories, namely bisexual and sexual and unisexual. Bisexual is also called by the term homothallic. Unisexual is called by the term heterothallic. Sexuality in algae, fungi, bryophytes, which may be either bisexual or may be unisexual. In the case of bisexual, homothallic, the fusing gametes formed on the same plant or on the same thallus. Example, the species of Rhizopus, namely Rhizopus sexualis, where both the gametes are formed by the same thallus. Unisexual, on the other hand, called by the term heterothallic, where the fusing gametes are formed from separate thalli or from separate strains. Example, Rhizopus stolonifer, similarly Marchantia. In the case of flowering plants, the unisexual flowers, which I already I said that it containing either the male or the female sex organs. So, based upon the presence of the male or female sex organs, the flower may be staminate flower if it bearing the male sex organs, or called by the term male flower. On the other hand, pistillate flowers which bearing the female sex organ, so commonly called female flowers. Again, if the male and the female flowers present in the same plant, the plant is called by the term monoecious. So, where you can see different flowers, some will be male flowers, some will be the female flowers. Example, coconuts, Cocos nucifera, similarly cucurbita. Similarly, there are plants where the male flower is seen in a separate plant, so commonly called male plant. Similarly, the female flower is seen on another plant, commonly called female plant. Such plants are usually called by the term dioecious. Example, date palm. Another example is papaya. Bisexual flowers are very common in the nature, where the bearing, the stamens, the male sex organ, and carpels are the pistil, the female sex organs. Sexuality in animals. Most of the animals are unisexual. Whereas in the case of plants, most of the plants are bisexual. Some are bisexual in animals. Example, earthworm, sponge, tapeworm, leech, gametogenesis. The word itself reflecting the mode of formation of gametes or the production of gametes is commonly called gametogenesis. Single type of gametes, already we have said, called homogametic species, or the gametes are two types, namely male and female, so called heterogametic species. The gametes are always haploid. Gametogenesis by mitosis in the case of haploid organism. For example, in Monera, fungi, algae, where the gametes are produced from the gametophytic plant body, which are haploid in nature. In some cases, the plant body will be diploid, where they produce the gametes, which are again haploid by means of reduction division or meiosis. So that's why I said earlier that always the gametes are haploid. If the plant body is haploid, the gametes are produced by mitotic event. On the other hand, if the plant body is diploid, the gametes are produced by meiotic event or reduction divisions. Meiosis of specialized cells are commonly called meiocytes, or we can put another way, gametic mother cells. Most of the animals are like this. The chromosome number of the meiocytes and gametes are variable. For example, in man, the gametic number is 23, whereas the diploid cell have got 46. So, like this, in the Ophioglossum, highest in the living organism, namely 1260, whereas in gamete, it comprising 630. So, the diploid and haploid number vary among the organisms. The second stage is the transfer of gametes for aiding the phenomena fertilization. That is, bringing the male and female gametes together for the event called fertilization. In the case of algae and fungi, mostly the gametes are motile. In majority of the organism, male gamete alone is motile, female gamete is stationary. The medium for gamete transportation is usually water. Male gametes are produced in enormous numbers to compensate for the loss during transportation. Gametic transfer in animal is by special mechanisms. In the case of flowering plants, the transfer of male gamete to the female gamete is commonly called by the term pollination. We can define the pollination is transfer of pollen grains, the male gametophyte, which containing the male gametes, towards the female gametes, which will be located safely within the female gametophyte, also called by the term embryo sac. The embryo sac is seated inside the ovule. So, this transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma of the carpel is commonly called pollination. So there are a lot of agents which facilitate pollination in plants, which may be either air or it may be wind or by using animals. Again, there are two terms commonly linking with pollination in plants. One is self-pollination and another one is cross-pollination. In self-pollination, the pollen grains are transferred from the anther of a flower to the stigma of the same flower or another flower on the same plants. So, this is commonly called self-pollination. So, the pollen grains are either deposited in the stigma of the same flower or the pollen grains are transferred to the stigma of another flower on the same plants. The end point is same, called with the term self-pollination. Meanwhile, in the cross-pollination, the pollen grains are transferred from one flower to another flower on a different plant. So, where the transfer is through some agents, like it may be wind, or it may be through some insects or birds, or through the medium water. Usually, after completing the self-pollination or cross-pollination, the pollen grains germinating on the stigma, producing long narrow tubes called pollen tubes, which carry male gametes towards the female gamete located or seated safely within the embryo sac. The second term is fertilization. It is also called by the term synchemy, where fusion of gametes occur. That is, male gamete fusing with the female gametes. So, the haploid male gamete plus the haploid female gamete leads to the formation of a diploid structure known by the term zygote. This event is technically called as fertilization. The most vital event in sexual reproduction. So, a common term, embloid, commonly seen in a number of organisms known by the term parthenogenesis, where the female gametes without any fertilization directly develop into zygotes. So, no fertilization occurs. Example, honeybees, certain lizards, birds such as turkey, where the parthenogenesis commonly accounted. The mode of fertilization is again categorized into two, namely external fertilization and second one is called internal fertilization. External fertilization means where fertilization occurs outside the body, or we can put in another way, it is occurring in the external medium, mostly water. So, the male and female gametes are fusing in the surrounding medium is commonly called external fertilization. In this case, synchronization is very essential between the sexes for effectively to carry the external fertilization. Again, in external fertilization, the male gamete number will be far in numbers or numerous in numbers. Production of large number of progenies. The disadvantage is that the progenies are vulnerable to predators. Only a very few will be surviving. Example, algae, fishes, amphibians. The second category known by the term internal fertilization, where the synchemy occurs inside the body of the organisms, or the male and female gametes are fusing within the body of the organism. Mostly the male gametes are transferred to the female gametes, where they go for fertilization. The female gametes is usually called by the term egg, formed inside the body of the female. The male gametes are usually motile, or they have got some passive movements, reach towards the female gametes. The sperms are produced in large numbers. Only a very few reach towards the egg. In seed plants, transfer of sperms is mediated by pollen tube. So anyway, the male gamete fusing with the female gametes within the cell or within the body of the organism. So we are putting the word internal fertilization. The third event, the post-fertilization events. Events in fertilization after the formation of zygote is commonly called post-fertilization changes. That is, the zygote has to develop into young ones. These events are collectively called post-fertilization changes. What is zygote? Zygote representing the diploid cell formed by the fusion of male and female gametes, or it is a consequence of the event called synchemy. Development of zygote depends on the life cycle environment. In fungi and algae, it develops a thick resistant wall protecting the zygotic cell from desiccation and damage. So only after the resting period they undergo the event called germination. There are two types of life cycle, haplotic life cycle. So it is also placed as meiotic division. Haploid spores, haploid individuals. On the other hand, in diploidic life cycle, mitotic division, diploidic individuals, or the individuals will be diploids. So the zygote germinating, developing into the new generation. The last event is embryogenesis. So the word clearly narrates the mode of development of embryo from zygotic cells. That is, the process of development of embryo from the zygotes. During embryogenesis, the zygotic cell undergo cell division and cell differentiation. So once it completing the cell division and the differentiation, the embryo will be formed. While cell division increases the number of cells in the developing embryo, cell differentiation helps groups of cells to undergo modifications to form specialized tissues or organ of the organisms. So both are required. The zygotic cell has to divide and also undergo the even differentiations for producing the complete organisms. In the case of animals, we can categorize them into two types, namely oviparous and also viviparous, based on whether the development of zygote occur within the body of the organism or outside the body of the organisms. In the oviparous animals like reptiles, birds, the fertilized egg is covered by a hard calcareous shell and which will be released into the environment. After a period of incubation, young ones are hatching from the zygotic cells. So commonly called oviparous organisms. In the case of viviparous animals, the zygotic cell develops within the body of the organisms. That is, zygote develop into young one inside the body of the female organisms. After attaining a certain stages of growth, the young ones are delivered or released from the body of the organisms. So that is commonly called viviparous organisms, because the proper embryonic care and protection, the chance of survival of young ones is greater in the case of viviparous organisms. For example, certain plants like mangroves, which are plants growing in marshy environments, where also the young ones are developed, or the seed is germinated, only the germinated seed falling into the soil. Since the plants are growing in the marshy environments, if the seed is directly falling in the environment, it never germinates. So, not only in animals, certain plants like mangrove, for example, Avicennia, a typical mangrove member, adapt viviparous germination. In plants, especially flowering plants, the zygote is formed inside the ovule, because the embryo sac is located within the ovule. So, the zygote is safer within the ovule. After fertilization, the peripheral parts of the flower, namely sepal, petals and stamens, withers off or fall off. The zygote develop into embryo and the ovules into the seeds. That is, the ovule changing into the seed and the ovary developing into the fruits. The wall of the ovule becomes the wall of the seed, namely the seed coats. The wall of the ovary developing into the fruit wall or the pericarp. After dispersal, the seeds germinating under favorable conditions to produce the new plants. So, that's the category, namely sexual mode of reproduction in plants as well as in animals. Now we will discuss some of the pertaining questions in sexual reproductions. So you can trace the answers from the class. The first question is, the stage of growth of a young plant till it produces flowers is known as option A, growth phase, option B, ontogeny, option C, differentiation of animals, option D, juvenile stage, option E, anthesis. Initially, I said that sexual reproduction comprises certain stages. So, you can trace the answer from there. The answer is option D, the juvenile phase. It refers the period of growth from germination of seeds to the reproductive maturity of a plant is called by the term juvenile phase, or also known by the term vegetative phase. So, the correct option is option D, juvenile phase. Question number 2. Which among the following is a multineal plant? So, the plants are categorized into 4 major types: annual, biennial, perennial, multineal. So, here the question is, which among the following is a multineal plant? Option A, jackfruit tree. Option B, Strobilanthus kundiana, neelakurinji. Option C, carrot. Option D, rice. Option E, mango. The correct answer is Neelakurinji or Strobilanthus kundiana. The plant grows along the Nilgiri belts, multineal plant that lives for 12 years as non-reproductive plants, produce flowers and seeds at the ends and immediately die. I have also given another example in the class, namely bamboo, which is also belong to the category called multineal plants. The next one is cyclic changes during reproduction in non-primate mammals is known as, I repeat, cyclic changes during reproduction in non-primate mammals is known as option A, sexual cycle, B, reproductive cycle, C, estrus cycle, D, simply life cycle, E, menstrual cycle. So, I said about the primates and non-primates. The correct answer is estrus cycle. It includes the cyclic changes in the activities of ovaries, accessory ducts and hormones during the reproductive phase of the life cycle of non-primate mammals is commonly called estrus cycle. Next one is the development of new organism without fertilization is known as option A, parthenocarpy, option B, parthenogenesis, option C, double fertilization, option D, diagenesis, option E, somatogenesis. So, the young ones are formed either by fertilization or by non-fertilization. So, what is the term employed for development of young ones without fertilization? The correct answer is parthenogenesis, formation of young ones directly from the female gamete without fertilization is called by the term parthenogenesis. Example, I have quoted honeybee, rotifers, some lizards, some birds, which normally go for parthenogenesis. So, this is a difficult pattern of question. Examine the following statements in sexual reproduction and identify the incorrect statements. So, there are 5 statements are given. So, you can go through the statement and identify the incorrect statements. The first one, transition between juvenile, reproductive and senescent phase in the life cycle of an organism is under the control of hormones. B, embryogenesis is the most vital event in sexual reproduction. C, gametogenesis involves meiotic division of specialized cells called meiocytes. D, anthrozoites and ovum are example for heterogametes. So, from there you can choose the incorrect statement related with sexual reproduction. The answer is B. It is not embryogenesis but fertilization. That is the most important event in sexual reproduction. There are many lower organisms such as algae, bryophytes, fungi in which embryogenesis is not at all essential even during sexual mode of reproduction. So, the option is B. The next question is the continuity of species between organisms of one generation to the next is ensured by the continuity of species between organisms of one generation to the next is ensured by dash. Option A, gametes. B, zygote. C, embryo. D, meiosites. E, gametes and meiosites. The answer is zygote. Zygote is formed by the fusion of gametes, which ensure the continuity between the generations. So the explanation is ensure the continuity of species from generation to generation, as the diploid set of chromosome typical of a species is maintained by the formation of zygotes by fertilization. So the answer is zygotes. If the chromosome number in the butterfly is 380, the chromosome number of its gametes would be dash. So, a small mathematical question. So, the diploid number is given as 380. What will be the nature of gametes? The options are 760, B 150, C 380, D 190, and E is 200. So, there are two stages, diploid and haploid. The answer is 190. Gametes are usually formed by meiotic division or reduction division. So, the original chromosome number of the parental cell will be reduced to half. So, there are two gametes, male and female. So, by the fusion of haploid male with the haploid female gametes, the diploid number will be retained or regained. So, the correct answer is option D, 190. Match the following and select the correct option. So, I have given two columns. The first column comprises 1 monoecious, 2 hermaphrodite, 3 dioecious, 4 oviparous, 5 viviparous. In the column number 2, the options are A, date palm, B, dog, C, birds, D, coconut, E, tapua. And below I have given the code of the options A, B, C, D and E. Carefully go through the options and find out the matching points between the column. The answer is option E. One is matching with the D. So, monoecious. So, monoecious means the plant bearing both female and male flowers, or male and female flowers are present in the same plant. So, the answer is coconut. Question number 2, hermaphrodites are animals with both male and female sex organs in the same organism. The example is tapeworm. 3, dioecious, where male and female flowers are seen in separate plants. Here the example is date palm. 4, oviparous, animals, the development of zygote takes place outside the body of the female parent, as in birds. The fifth one is viviparous, where the development of the zygote taking place inside the body of the female parents. So, taking more care. So, the option is E. So, there is another difficult question. Fill in the blanks in the following statements and choose the correct option. So, I have given two statements, 1, 2 and 3. 1, in cucurbits, dash flowers develop into fruits. 2, Rhizopus stolonifer is a dash fungus. 3. Embryogenesis involved mitosis of the zygote followed by cell dash. So the options are A. Pistillate heterothallic differentiation, B. Pistillate heterothallic de-differentiation, C. Staminate homothallic differentiation, D. Pistillate homothallic differentiation, E. Bisexual heterothallic differentiation. So carefully read the statement and find out the answer. The option is A. Cucurbita is a monoecious plant which staminate representing the male, pistillate representing the female. The female flower is developing into the fruits. So, pistillate cucurbita. Second is heterothallic. Rhizopus stolonifer is a heterothallic fungus as there are separate male and female thalli involved in sexual reproduction. Differentiation. Embryogenesis involves mitotic division of the zygotic cell into several diploid cells that undergo differentiation to form the different tissues of the embryo. So that means a zygotic cell has to divide followed by differentiation. So the option is option A. So again, another difficult question. Examine the following statements on the process of fertilization. Identify the incorrect ones. Number one, the process of fertilization is otherwise known as syncome. Two, there is no reproduction in the absence of fertilization. Three, fertilization occurs in animals such as fishes is known as external fertilization. 4. In pteridophytes and gymnosperms, male gametes are non-motile, hence carried to the female gametes by pollen tube. 5th one, fertilization always results in the formation of a diploid cell, the zygotic cell. The options are A, 4 and 5. B, 3 and 4, C, 2 and 4, E, 1 and 2. So, find out the incorrect statements, not the correct statement. Option is C, 2 and 4 are incorrect statements. Reproduction is possible by asexual means and in the absence of fertilization, as in some organisms, such as rotifers, honeybees, lizards, birds, such as turkey, by means of parthenogenesis, in which the ovum develops into new organism without any fertilization. So, it is an incorrect statement. The second one is fourth option. In seed plants, such as gymnosperms, male gametes are non-motile and hence carried to the female gamete by pollen tube. While in pteridophytes, the male gametes are flagellate and motile and move to the non-motile egg in the archegonium through the medium of water. So, the statement given is wrong. So, the options are 2 and 4. So, hope that now you got a clear picture regarding the entire spectra of reproduction. One side there will be asexual. Other side there will be sexual. So, they are fundamentally different in mode and also in developments. In the next class, we will study in detail the sexual reproduction. Thank you.